देविका जाधव एंड आई फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 10A. माय स्कूल्स नेम इज विद्या प्रतिष्ठान्स न्यू बाल विकास मंदिर पिंपरी बारामती एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक इट्स लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ स्टार्स. वी एवरीवन हैज हर्ड दिस पोएम इट इज ट्विंकल ट्विंकल लिटिल स्टार हाउ आई वंडर व्हाट यू आर. सो वी सी स्टार्स इन द नाइट स्काई बट डू वी नो द ओरिजिन और व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन विद देम एट द एंड. सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक सम इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स अलॉन्ग विद द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ स्टार्स. Like we have our origin from our parents, similarly stars also have their origin from their parents. The parents is none other but a star nursery. We can share a image picture of a star nursery. Now the clouds which are present inside the star nursery are a combination of a gases such as hydrogen and helium. So when a disturbance occurs through it, the hydrogen and the helium gas started to collapsing with each other, resulting in the formation of two types of stars. That is, first one is the average size star and the second is massive size star. First, let's talk about the average size star. This average size star, the example of this is our sun. Scientists predict that after 5 billion years ago, our sun is going to end up its life, it's going to get converted into a red giant. Now, how it's going to happen? The hydrogen gas which is present inside our sun is continuously burning and turning into a helium gas. So, when the hydrogen gas is going to run out of fuel, it's going to get converted into a red giant. This red giant is going to split into a layers. When the red giant is going to form, this red giant is going to expand and it's going to englobe the planets such as Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars. This is the fact about the red giant. It's going to split into a layers like an onion has a layers. Now, after this, it's going to get converted into a planetary nebula. We can see here a gases which is split out. These gases are none other but the hydrogen and the helium gas. Only the core is left inside them. At the fourth stage, that is the end stage of an average size star, the core which is left is going to get converted into a white dwarf. That white dwarf has a very small size because it depends on the size of a core. This white dwarf has a greater density as compared to its origin. This was a whole life cycle process of an average size star. Now let's move on to the second, that is a massive size star. Similarly, the massive size star is going to get converted into a red giant. But it's not only a red giant, it is a red supergiant because it varies in their size. After the super red giant, it's going to get converted into a supernova. We can see a gases which are splitting out and only a core is left inside them. Now this core has an option. It can either get converted into neutron star or either into black hole. Now how neutron star? The atoms which are there inside the core, that is subatomic particles like proton and electron, are going to get smashing with each other and they are going to melt each other, resulting in the formation of neutron star, as only neutrons are left in that core. This neutron star has a greater density, and it's going to have a greater density than that of a massive size star. It's similar to white dwarf, but it varies in the size. This white dwarf has a small size, its scan ranges up to 10 km, and this neutron star has a great size, it ranges up to 20 km, that is 12.4 miles. Now, the second option is that black hole. Everyone has heard about black hole. The black holes are the weirdest question to the history for the scientists and the astronomers. This anything which goes inside a black hole is going to, no one knows that whether the thing which is entered inside the black hole has an end or it's alive or dead. So, if an astronomer is roaming around the black hole, nobody knows whether he is alive or dead. So, the astronomer is going to turn into a spaghetti-like shape and is going to get inside the black hole. So, this is the whole story of a black hole and this is the whole process of a life cycle of stars. But not least, I would conclude with that the sun which we see today, which gives us energy, heat, light, or we can say the reason for which the sun is a reason for which we are existence, and tomorrow it will be the reason for our extinction. Thank you.